Hello, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. We are moments away from kickoff, and we've got a good one on tap between the Carolina Panthers and the Kansas City Chiefs. With that, we're out to Arrowhead for the call from Kansas City. We'll hand it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle with Cam Newton and the Carolina Panthers. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden, and as we look at this matchup, every time there's something different to focus on. So I'll just ask you, what do you see here in this one?
Well, Rembrandt, you've given me a pretty blank canvas to focus on, haven't you?
Yeah.
Where do you think I'm going to go with this?
Oh, secondary?
You know me. You know me well, right? In a game like this, it's always about the secondary. Can they handle the passing attack and make a few plays?
Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And into a sea of red, we're underway in Kansas City. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. They're led out by their big-bodied electric quarterback, Cam Newton.
Cam has all the skills that you're looking for. The arm that can do everything. The ability to run, hard to bring down because of his size. But the joy that he plays the game, I think that's his stock in trade. That's his calling card. That's what sets him apart from other players.
Newton. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Still going. Charvarius Ward there to make the stop. When we look at this unit like we are now, Greg Olsen has become such a reliable target in this league.
Loves to be considered the number one option in the passing game in the offense he plays, and he lives up to it. Knows the defense is set for him, knows how to beat them.
This is Newton off the play fake to McCaffrey. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Give him 18. It's a Carolina first down. A little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play, and gave up a bigger one instead.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 42-yard line. Boy, nowhere to go at all on that first down run as they will get to him behind the line of scrimmage.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run. Stop your whining.
On second and 11 now. Newton, and a big loss here as he's taken down. Tyrann Mathieu, normally known for the pass coverage, this time a sack.
Enough takes to start down a good drive, quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Newton to throw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. They get a big amount back, 18 yards, but they'll still look at a fourth down now. And he's already got two catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
Fourth down, and here's Graham Gano now in the field goal unit for the Panthers. This from 54 yards away. And this one is right down Broadway. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. So here are the Chiefs now under their veteran head coach, Andy Reid. As we get a peek at the former Red Raider and 10th pick in the 2017 draft, Patrick Mahomes. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Mahomes going to pull it out and keep it himself. A quick throw out wide caught by Robinson. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Mahomes going to throw. It's Kelce on the ground. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and Travis Kelce will be key.
What a tremendous weapon he is, especially in the red zone. Knows how to find the end zone when running his routes.
The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Gets this one to Hill. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the third down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up 4th down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3-and-out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure he didn't give up much run after catch.
On 4th down, on is Dustin Colquitt to kick this away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Taken in at the 11. Shedding the tackle. And just bowling over tacklers. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. So Newton and the Panthers come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. Give him 18. It's a Carolina first down. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now it's Newton. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Frank Clark fighting his way home to get the sack. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Go, And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Now Newton. This is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain there of 21 yards. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
Newton will bring him up first and 10. And he's a perfect 5-for-5 here to begin the game. This is McCaffrey.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense.
I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it.
And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. And there the counterplay proves successful for the touchdown. What typically makes a counterplay in general successful, Charles?
But what you're trying to do, Brandon, is to get the team moving in one direction, meaning the defense. Get them going in one direction and then wall them off with your blocking and bring it back in the other direction. That way, you don't actually have to punish them with your blocking. You just position them. And if you have any kind of a good back, he'll take full advantage of it and gain good yardage.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now here comes Kansas City.
And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically, what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for. Luke Kuechly combines speed, intelligence, toughness, puts it all together. It makes plays like one we just saw there. He may not be a big-time blitzer, but boy, he knows how to pursue straight ahead and make plays in the run game.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Open man is Hill. He's got it. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. Yellow. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
You ain't got nothing. You ain't got nothing.
Working from the gun, Mahomes. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. K-1 short with a sack. That's 315 pounds of man right there. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. Fielded at about the 28. That'll be a 47-yard punt, officially 5 on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And the Panthers coming out now. They've got the lead, and certainly a big reason why some of these catches we take a look at right now.
And I've seen it so many times that when units start to play really well, they feed off of each other and play even better. And they're making every catch possible. Contested, non-contested, easy, difficult, big-time plays. And right now, that's why their team's in the lead.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Here's Newton. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Panther first down. Newton will bring him up first and 10. And he's a perfect 6-for-6 here to start the ball game. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Play action. It's Newton. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of 1, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
The last completion actually lost a yard, so now they'll need to convert on 3rd down. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. Still fighting. What a play that turns out to be. 36 yards. What a luxury to have a tight end that can not only catch it, but then can run after the catch like that.
What was the old expression back in the good old days that they used to carry pianos on their backs when they were after they caught the football? Someone would stop and bang out a tune along the way as well. But nowadays, these guys are essentially bulked up wide receivers, and they are a full part of the passing game, and we see a lot of big plays as we just saw there.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on 1st down. Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey. And the 2nd wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on 1st down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's 2nd and 11. Throwing is Newton. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Frank Clark picks up his 2nd sack of the afternoon. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing 3rd and long. Newton now to throw. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. You and I have seen some great catches throughout our days calling these games. A spectacular grab there, just a receiver making a wonderful play.
When there's a chance to get 6 points on the board, you see a little extra effort sometimes. A terrific layout to go get the football.
Gano for the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. So that drives 7 plays in length. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over.
And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the 2nd quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
No, but let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
You're down 3 scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination.
I think you just called a desperation time. I think you did. But let's face it, you men mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
Boy, he ran free there after the catch as that winds up going for 38 for an offense that has not found the end zone yet. That's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. Complete, the tight end Kelce. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. This will be their first trip to the red zone. They've got it first and goal to go. Now here's Mahomes. That's complete. It's Bell. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. That's good for a gain of six. Second and goal. Second and goal from inside the five. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Taking it in from 4 yards out as they are now on the board here in the first half.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And it's 17-7. The drive summary, four plays, 75 yards. And in the end, it was all capped off by the Damian Williams touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. And the good news, his team's winning. And the bad news, he hasn't had the game that he's hoped to, at least to this point here in the second quarter.
And a lot of that is pride, because these types of backs want to be in the center of all the action and leading their team to victory. They'll take the win right now, hoping to jump his game up as this one moves on.
And he probably wants a little bit more of the spotlight going forward. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. He finds an opening past the 40. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 44-yard line. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clear shot on him. Plus, he moves it a lot faster than what people think. And boy, does he have fun playing the game of football.
Now a first down throw for Newton. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he'll finally be taken down at the 18. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Newton will bring him up first and 10. And he's now 10 of 10 throwing the ball here to start the game.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. The Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu, there defensively to make the play. On second and 10, Newton buying time to his left. He's going to take off with it. Sheds off the tackle and give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain. Newton on third down. Being chased out left. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Jarius White there to make the grab. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Gano now to add the extra point. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. A drive that time of six plays, and Carolina scores to cap it off. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City.
And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way things have gone, they need to try to make something happen offensively.
But maybe they should. Maybe they should sit on it here because of what you just said. They haven't made anything happen offensively. Getting ready to go into the half, give them a chance to take a deep breath, exhale a little bit, and start over. I don't know if this is the time to push it myself.
Yeah, right now, under 100 yards of total offense.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. Mahomes now to throw. This is caught by Williams. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. Finding Williams once more, complete. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes, it's Hill, complete. So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked.
We're going to shut you down. We're going to shut you down.
So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one is maybe not exactly in the bag yet, but there is definitely a big mountain to climb in this third quarter. The teams are already back out there, so let's not waste any time, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
Now a pass that's taken in by Hill. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Chiefs first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll run out of the gun here. Williams. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just pin their ears back and get after him now.
And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. First down for the Chiefs. Solid chunk of yardage, 17 on the play.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
Down carry, it's Williams, and down inside the 15 he goes. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air, but in a sense that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6. Throwing is Mahomes on third.
Purple.
And that is caught by Watkins for a Chief touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard and you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
The extra point splits the uprights. And the lead down to 10, 24-14. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down here in this third quarter, so time to retool a bit.
And probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively. Because a lot of times we think it's just play calls and this isn't working and they're shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for here.
Trying to get that edge back as they've watched this lead shrink a little.
They had a chance to limit his yardage, but he was able to fight off that tackle.
So it's not just the responsibility of the guys who missed the tackles along the way. It's all Lebanon defense able to stop this guy, unable to do it on that play. They've got to find a way. How about his ability to break through and gain that yardage?
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. McCaffrey, a strong running. McCaffrey with a first down and more. 13 yards, first down, Panthers.
We saw it at Stanford. It does not surprise me to see it here in the NFL as well. This is one elusive young man.
He set the NCAA record in 2015, 3,864 all-purpose yards.
Listen, after watching that move, I just called for the trainer. I think I pulled a hammy just watching him.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop him. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Here we go. 180.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. He'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19. Throwing on second and eight, Newton. Flushed out right. He's going to take off with it. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
Touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Extra point try, good by Gadeau. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So this drive spans seven plays. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Gadeau now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged, how big a mistake and when it occurred.
Now Robinson coughs up the football. It's loose, and the Panthers have recovered. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free. Anything you can do to slow them down.
Out comes Christian McCaffrey with the rest of the offense. He's had a good performance, moved the ball effectively on the ground. Of course, he has the one touchdown.
And when you're able to move it as effectively as you've described, that leads to finding a way into the end zone, and now he's just trying to do it for a second time.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Emmanuel Ogba in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Throwing on second and long. Newton dancing to his left. And now he's going to use his legs. So both teams trade touchdowns in the third as we're through three quarters of play. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL and it's on EA Sports. Newton on first down. And he's got his man. It's Samuel. Touchdown, Carolina. Curtis Samuel there to make the grab. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Gano for the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And Carolina scores to cap it off. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Good word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
you
right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long. They've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Now defensively, you look at the numbers, another incomplete pass that we just saw, and they're under 200 yards passing for the game, so they've done their job on that side of the ball.
Yeah, recently I was actually working a game where a quarterback had a streak of 5 straight games without a 200-yard game, and that was a big talk both in his town and amongst his team. How do we get the passing game going? So big credit to them holding them under 200 today.
You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Mahomes now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. This is caught by Robinson. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 as they're down to the 29-yard line. Now it's Mahomes again.
This is complete to Watkins on the slant. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
On first down, Williams looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. They run it again with Williams. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
We've seen this a few times in this game. That offensive line just, I don't know if you want to call it out-physical, out-toughed, whatever you want to use.
And what people do when that is happening, when they're getting dominated that way, they spread things out a little bit, make it more of a space game, and allow your skill position players to make a few plays out in open field. Take away the physical element, gives you a chance.
From the gun on third down, Mahomes. And that is incomplete.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth.
Push him back. Push him back.
They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. Travis Kelce there to make the grab. And the Chiefs are able to draw a bit closer. Wow, talk about a big fourth down conversion for the score defensively. How do you let that happen?
Man, I think you start with the offense and you give them credit for going for it and having that type of, well, let's face it, audacity. But defensively, I think you're right on target, partner. There's no way something like that's supposed to happen in that situation. You're supposed to be able to shut that down and get the ball back for your own team. Instead, they give up not just a big play, but a touchdown.
They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for. And this touchdown will count.
Here's Mahomes to throw. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line.
Tried to roll out, make a play outside of the pocket, but couldn't get it done.
When you don't have a lot of space for your receivers to operate, and down there is really condensed when you're snapping the ball from the 2-yard line, rolling out, you extend a play, but you don't necessarily open up better avenues for people. And on that play, there's just nowhere to go with the ball, and you end up getting sacked.
So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And it looks like the Panthers' hands team does its job. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey.
Charvarius Ward in on the tackle. And what do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Newton. Forced out to his left. And they get to Newton and take him down for the sack. And Cam Newton's not coming off the field. They'll keep the offense out to go for it on fourth. And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. On the tackle, Tyrann Mathieu. On second and 7, Newton escaping the pressure right. He'll try and run it. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. On the ground, McCaffrey. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already. And he's going to ball his way in for a Panther score. Christian McCaffrey with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
And Brad, I think we have to look back at the big call to go for it on fourth down.
Yeah, that set up everything. And the end result, the short touchdown run. You know, correct me if I'm wrong, I don't think every coach would have gone for it back there.
You and I both know every coach would not have gone for it back there. So that's showing a little bit of faith, actually showing a lot of faith in his team, and it was rewarded.
Gano the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And the last play on the drive, the touchdown run from Christian McCaffrey. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now here comes Kansas City. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. To throw again on second down, Mahomes. Yeah, this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. Nice play for Kansas City, picking up the first 18 yards that time. Now on first down, and this is caught by Watkins. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down, facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Now Williams, and they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's 2nd down. They work again from the 38 on 2nd and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. It's Williams on the catch. The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on 3rd and inches. Mahomes going to throw, and that is incomplete, 7 seconds remaining. The All-Pro linebacker Luke Kuechly right there on the coverage, stride for stride.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Mahomes going to go on fourth down. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Panthers will get the football back. Back to throw, Newton. Taking a shot for Samuel. That's caught inside the 20. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lanyap, a little extra on top.
I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who's really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. Partner, I think the thing I'm going to take away from this game is that ending. Still hard to believe they score on the final play, and then for some salt on the wound, they go for two just to widen the margin.
Not to mention they already had the lead when they scored on the final play. So I don't know if everyone on the team is a fantasy football player, and they're like, hey, get more points for our guys. I don't know what's going on here. Maybe a coach is looking ahead and saying, you know something, the more points we have might be the tiebreaker. But boy, what a way to finish it.
So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gott. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.